Taxi's here.
Already?
You wouldn't want Mossy to miss the train, would you?
Yeah, I would. Wouldn't mind it a bit.
Oh, now, Sam, get your feet out of the way.
Just listen to that meter ticking. Shut off your meter. She'll be right down.
Good morning, Mr. Lewis.
Oh, hello, John.
You're losing Mossy today, huh?
She's not dying, you know. She's just going to Chicago.
Oh, Sam, stop shouting.
That's the year she wanted to be an actress. Pretty good, too. Oh, I remember this. Remember the summer she won it? Most popular girl at Camp Wadahami.
Such excitement. Oh, Mother, you're an angel for helping me with all this. I'll finish. You just sit down and talk to me.
No, I'll help.
How I'm going to get all these clothes in here, I'll never know.
Does this go?
Yeah.
Did Rodney leave?
Yes, he wanted to come down the train, Dad, but I thought that was silly. It's a working day.
He's a nice boy.
Sam, bring the things from the dresser, will you? We've all agreed that if this is what Mossy wants to do, she should do it.
Well, I just thought maybe it wouldn't be a bad idea if she stayed and married him. Where do you want these?
Here, I'll take them. Oh, he's sweet, Dad, but it's strictly a business arrangement.
Oh, that's too bad, because I think...
Go sit down, dear. I gave him an idea for his canning factory to can whole family dinners. They come in sets, everything from soup to desserts.
Say, that's a wonderful idea.
It's working out, too.
Darling, doesn't your head ever get tired of these things?
Mine does.
Oh, before I forget, I ordered the stove, and if they don't bring it on Monday, you better call them, Mother.
Will do.
Let me see, I canceled my speech to the advertising club. My robe. When the gardener puts in the dahlias, tell him not to put them so close to the fence.
Well, that's your department.
Uh-huh.
Oh, and before I forget, we've got a credit of $3.50 at the meat market. If you go down there, Mother, ask for Marty.
Marty? He must be new.
Yeah, and I was thinking, Daddy, when you buy your new suit, ask him to show you some pinstripes. I think they'd look good on you.
Oh, you do? Mm-hmm.
And guess where I put your pipe cleaners?
Where?
In your top desk drawer.
Well, it'll be nice having them where they belong.
Well, now you two take care of yourself while I'm away.
Oh, we'll be all right.
We'll be all right.
Guess that's it.
Well, we'd better stop. The taxi's waiting.
Well, what's the hurry? The taxi can wait. Oh, we're going to miss you, honey.
Well, I'm going to miss you, too. I might be back. Maybe they'll turn me down.
No, they won't. But let me give you some advice. Don't give them a million suggestions your first day. You know, don't take over all at once. They've probably been getting along fine up until now. And when you go in for your interview, just say no, sir, and yes, sir. Will you remember that?
Yes, sir.
How do you do?
I'm Marcy Lewis.
Sit down, Miss Lewis.
Thank you very much, Mr. Williams.
I thought you wrote a very impressive letter. So you're from Havenville, Indiana?
Yes, sir.
Do you like it there?
Yes, sir.
Where'd you go to school?
Havenville.
Tell me about your parents.
They're living.
Tell me, what made you decide to become an airline stewardess?
I had a friend who was one. She...
Yes?
She likes it.
You know, Miss Lewis, sometimes girls who are very well adapted to other things aren't quite suited to this kind of work. Oh, it's no reflection on the individual. 95% of our applicants are rejected.
You mean I'm not accepted?
I'm afraid not.
Yes, sir.
You see, we're looking primarily for girls who like to meet people and take care of them. A stewardess is the greatest salesman an airline can have. We've got to be very particular.
But you're absolutely right, Mr. Williams. If you had a girl who was tongue-tied and couldn't take care of people, you'd have the passengers at each other's throats. And I love meeting people, and I love flying. You know, an airplane is more than just a piece of metal. It's a home in the air. That might be a wonderful slogan for our company. Your home in the air. If you don't like that one, Mr. Williams, I've got a lot of other slogans. I've wanted to be an airline stewardess ever since I can remember. Aviation is the most exciting thing in the world. You know, God didn't mean people to be strangers. And with commercial aviation, people all over the world are becoming neighbors. Let me tell you about my uncle that used to fly in the last war. He was my mother's brother, but you won't believe this. When he started to fly...
June, you go to dormitory DC-3. That's the first room.
Thanks.
Hello.
Hello, I'm Marcy Lewis.
I'm Ann White, and this is Miss Wells.
Hello, Miss White. Hello, Miss Wells.
Hello.
You're assigned to dormitory DC-6. That's the second room down.
Thank you.
I think you'll find everything you need there.
Thank you very much.
Joyce Davis?
Hi. Hi, my name's Jan Baker.
Hi, Marcy Lewis.
Welcome.
Oh, I'm exhausted. I wonder which one's mine.
Take any bed. I feel like an old-timer. I've been here 10
minutes.
Mind
if I take the one next to yours?
No, we're probably the oldest friends here.
Hey, he's cute. Is he yours?
Mm-hmm.
To Jan with my highest esteem.
Roger's not very emotional. Now, I haven't found what I've forgotten yet.
Oh.
Hello.
I'm Alice Raymond. I'm from Memphis.
I'm Jan Baker.
That's cute.
Oh, and that's Marcy Lewis.
Hello, Marcy.
Hi.
Aunt Clay, isn't this cozy?
Sleepy, honey?
Hello.
Hello.
I think I belong here. My name is Kathy Hunter.
Hi, Kathy, honey. This is Jan. That's Marcy.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Help yourself to a bed.
Oh, thanks. I can sure use one. I'm dead.
May I have your attention, please?
Will you get your things unpacked immediately and report to Miss White in 15 minutes?
Oh,
they can think faster around here. Airline service involves safety, capability, efficiency, and courtesy. A stewardess must not only make a good first impression, but a lasting one. Now, your first duty is to go directly to the cockpit, where you'll clean the captain's earphones and radio mouthpiece with Exuberol. Now, I'll show you how that's done. A little on the cotton. It's very simple.
Phew!
On a Convair, you'll work alone. On a DC-6, there are always two stewardesses. All right, Miss Wells.
Oh, honey, there's nothing to this at all!
I hope I didn't flunk that meteorology test.
Marcy, what's that? Marcy! What's that rule about air masses?
Oh, Alice. Since the general motion of the atmosphere in the United States is toward the east, the polar and Arctic air masses generally move toward the southeast.
Is that it? Oh.
Well, girls, I came here today to congratulate you. But after looking you over, I think I should congratulate our passengers. There's a lot of hard work ahead of you and a lot of fun. I won't keep you from it any longer. In case you're mildly curious about your assignments, they're in the next room.
Memphis. Well, this time tomorrow we'll be on our own flights.
I can't believe it.
Attention, please.
flight 485, leaving for Dallas.
Oh, that's me.
Don't worry, Kathy. You're not going to an execution.
I know, but I'm afraid I'm suddenly going to forget everything.
Oh, no, you're not. You're not nervous.
I'm not. Well, then why are my knees shaking?
Oh, Jan.
Goodbye, Marcy.
Goodbye.
Take care, Alice.
Attention, please. American Airlines flight 576 for Cleveland. Now ready at gate 11.
That's me!
All aboard, please.
Now you're both gonna be all right. You don't let anybody know that you're nervous, and don't let anybody know that you're scared. I guess I better get aboard. Goodbye, Jan. Goodbye, Alice. Now take care now.
Bye.
Don't you want your suitcase?
Oh,
that's right, honey. Don't be nervous.
I'm not. Good night.
Let Cleveland be nervous.
Cleveland Tower calling American Operations. American Operations.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Point killer.
283 is on the ground, Joe.
All right.
As I was saying, it was the most beautiful two-wing job you ever saw. I had smooth air all the way and was all set for a two-point landing.
What happened?
Her mother walked in.
Oh, all right.
Stewardess Marcy Lewis reporting for duty.
Meteorologist Hawkins.
Flight dispatcher Brown.
Williams, charge of crew schedules.
Allison, radio operator.
At ease, men. You're not going to fly in this weather.
But it's beautiful here.
Ah, but you're not flying here. You're going to fly to Nashville.
What's the weather in Nashville, Mr. Hawkins?
I don't know, sir. I'll look in the paper. They're expecting a tornado, sir.
But I love tornadoes. I've been out with the operations crew in Chicago.
Uh-oh. Welcome to the club.
Hello, hi. Fellas.
We'll check you in at a downtown hotel until you can find an apartment.
Thank you.
You'll go out in flight 783.
783.
Report back here tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock sharp.
11 o'clock.
Synchronize your watches, men. We're expecting big things of you.
Roger. Over. Out. Bye,
fellas. If you put the jack under the axle, I think you get a better leverage.
Yes, but this is a bumper jack.
Well, will you please hurry? I gotta be at the airport in 10 minutes.
I'm going as fast as I can.
I don't think there's enough of a fulcrum.
Look, lady, I've been jacking these cars all my life.
Oh, I'm gonna be so late.
Rocked in the cradle of the
Yeah, can I give you a lift?
Oh, wonderful. Here.
Oh, thank you.
Still say you got the wrong jack.
I've never been late for a flight.
No?
Oh, I'm a stewardess. You see, a stewardess must not only create a good first impression, but a lasting one.
Oh, really?
Would you mind driving just a little bit faster?
Oh, no.
An airline service involves safety, capability, efficiency, and courtesy. Do you do much flying?
Only a bit.
You like it?
Yes,
me too. No other way to travel. You know, I'm not really happy unless I'm in the air, taking care of my passengers and crew. Gives you a feeling that you're, well, indispensable.
You know, I never realized that a stewardess was so important.
Planes don't fly without us.
How about pilots?
Chauffeurs. Well, I can't thank you enough.
Well, I wouldn't have missed it for anything, Miss,
Oh, Lewis, Marcy Lewis.
Marcy Lewis.
Maybe we'll meet again sometime.
I hope so, Miss Lewis.
All right, thank you.
Is that all right?
Bye.
Goodbye. Chauffeurs.
Attention, please. American Airlines flight 183 from New York and Buffalo. Now arriving at gate 5.
Number one, sterilize captain's microphone.
Attention. Attention, please. American Airlines Flight 783 leaving for Nashville. Now ready at gate 4. All aboard, please.
Good morning. Good morning.
Your clearance slip.
Oh, thanks.
Have a nice trip.
Wait a minute. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I'll write to you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
What can we do for you?
Przepraszam pani, jestem taki nerwowy. Jestem pierwszy raz na aeroplanie. Ja chcę pić, proszę pani.
Oh, well, I'm afraid that I don't speak whatever
you're speaking. To jest nie moja wina, to pani nie rozumie po polsku. Proszę pani.
Let's keep on that stewardess.
Would you hold the baby, please?
Oh, yes.
That's what's wrong. Isn't she sweet?
It's a boy.
Miss, how about something to eat?
Oh, thank you very much. I just ate.
Oh, I forgot. Take the baby, please. Now, don't anybody go away. Oh, and everybody fasten your seatbelts. Hurry!
Well, it's about time.
Yes, sir.
This plane's flying on a schedule. When you get a clearance order, bring it to
me. Yes, sir. I'm terribly... What are you doing here?
I work here.
You didn't tell me you were...
Well, you didn't give me a chance.
Well, I'd like to explain about this morning.
Well, maybe we could go someplace and chat over a cup of coffee.
Oh, I'd love to, but we have to fly.
Oh, that's what's been on my mind. Now I remember. The tower has been asking me to take off. Now then, if it won't inconvenience you, I'd like to leave. Hmm?
All right.
Was you a little rough on her?
Well, that one needs a lesson.
I think she's kind of cute.
She's darling, fellas. Now, how about moving that ship?
Magazine?
Yes, please.
Magazine?
Here it is.
May I have a pillow, please?
Oh, yes. Wouldn't you like to take your hat off and be more comfortable?
Thank you so
Miss,
much.
If it isn't too much trouble, I'd like some lunch.
Well, of course, I'm going to serve right away. Here's something for you to read.
Time's lunch.
That's what I wanted to talk about. Well, you see, there was so much excitement and confusion, and then one of the passengers said he was hungry, and then I went to look. I forgot to check.
Not the food.
Yes, sir.
What?
Yes, sir.
Oh, of all the stewardesses in this country, I had to get to you. What I'd like to know is, what have I done to...
Hi, Sally.
A stewardess's job is to make a good impression. Now, of course, I'm only a chauffeur. But what I'd like you to know is what an impression you've made and how indispensable you've been.
Ready to go back for instructions.
Right.
Those passengers have to be fed. You know what that means?
783.
That means we have to go back to the airport. That's 15 minutes lost. Then land, that's 10 minutes lost. Then
the luck will
get up a half an hour later, and then we can start all over again. It's an hour lost, and you're sorry.
Maybe we won't have to. We're back.
But you didn't write.
Things like this happen often.
I've never seen this happen before. But don't judge by me. I've only been with the company for 15 years.
Are they terribly upset?
Well, you know how it is, schedules and all that nonsense. Look, if this aeroplane ever reaches Nashville, Mr. Thomas, the operations chief there, is very anxious to see you.
He is, huh?
Well, goodbye again.
Where do they get dames like that? He's a menace to commercial aviation.
Take it easy, Mike.
Well, you like a flying busboy.
Fellas, your lunches are packed. Would you like to make your airplane fly now? We have other planes to land.
Yeah. Here she comes! Hey, fellas!
Joe. What'd you say your name was?
Marcy Lewis.
Is Mike ready, sir?
Sir? He wanted a landed by parachute.
Thanks for everything, Marcy. Goodbye.
Dziękuję bardzo, panie. Pani jest taka grzeczna kobietka. Jestem bardzo zadowolony, proszę pani.
It's nice, and don't you worry about a thing.
We enjoyed the trip. Goodbye.
Well, I don't know, Mike. This is a pretty serious thing. We can't just overlook it.
Well, I'm not asking you to overlook it, Tommy. I just hope that you won't be too hard on her, that's all. Sure, she was excited. It was her first flight. She's great with passengers.
Well, I'll see.
Thanks, Tommy.
Mr. Thomas?
Yes. Come over here, Miss Lewis.
You know who I am?
The whole airline knows who you are. Aviation stocks are tumbling.
Oh, I said I was sorry. I tried to take care of all the passengers. I did everything I could to make them feel at home. Maybe I tried too hard, but anyway, I tried. Well, I don't mind. I can go back to Havenville. Furthermore, I'm going by bus. Goodbye.
Miss Lewis, you'd better check your schedule. Your next flight goes out in an hour.
My... Oh. Oh, thank you, Mr. Thomas. I promise you, you won't be sorry.
I hope not. You're flying with Mike Jameson.
Oh. Well, anyway, thank you.
And don't forget the lunches.
No, sir. Captain Jameson.
Oh.
You'll be disappointed to know that I'm not being fired.
Oh, you don't say.
Mr. Thomas was very understanding. He felt it could have been worse.
Yes. You could have forgotten your airplane. Came through?
No.
Yeah, you're assigned to the Chicago Los Angeles run.
Oh, Willie.
That came through for you, too.
Oh, thanks. Well, this is from my roommate. We're going to be on the same run together. She's going to meet me in Chicago.
Better get started. You're scheduled to leave at 3:00.
Come on, I'll buy some coffee.
Okay, Mike.
Me, too.
Anything the matter?
No, nothing. I just got my apartment furnished.
I'll see you before you go.
Flight 369, Chicago Midway Tower.
Chicago Tower. Go ahead, American Flight 369.
American Flight 369, in range over shoreline. Go ahead with landing instructions.
You're number 3 to land on runway 22L, wind southwest 5. Call on base leg.
American Flight 369.
perfume off. It spilled all over the microphone.
This way.
Well, I knew I had to do something, so I took my perfume out and put that on.
Oh, no.
I told you what happened on my first flight.
You didn't have to. Everybody talked about it for weeks.
Oh, this is darling. Mm-hmm. Who have you been flying with?
Oh,
me too. Aren't the pilots wonderful?
Absolutely.
Have you been having any fun?
Well, I...
Oh, I guess so.
Oh.
How is Roger?
Well, he hasn't married anybody else yet.
That's romantic of him. You know, you and I may have to do something about this boy.
Yeah. Hey, Marcy, do you realize that tomorrow we'll be flying the Mercury run to Hollywood?
You love Hollywood, Jan. It's a wonderful place. Everything out there is touched with a kind of magic.
Gee, it sounds wonderful. Oh. When were you there?
This will be my first trip.
Oh, honestly, Marcy.
What?
United Airlines mainliner service flight 608 from Los Angeles, now arriving at gate 2.
Jan.
Okay. Number three?
Mm-hmm. Did you take a look at all the passengers on board?
Mm-hmm. Why? Did anybody leave?
No, but there's a man named Michael Lawrence I've got a feeling about.
What kind of a feeling? I need two milks.
Nothing, except I think he's a VIP.
The list didn't say anything about a very important person.
Well, he isn't listed. It's just a feeling.
Sort of an intuition.
Yeah, sort of.
Think it's too early to get the desserts out?
Are you ready to serve?
Mm-hmm. Now, Marcy, these intuitions of yours are... Where is he?
Up front.
Top of his head looks fine. I'll take his dinner and let you know.
Thank you very much. Here's your dinner, Mr. Lawrence.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Did you enjoy your dinner, Mr. Lawrence?
Yes, thank you.
Did you have enough?
Yes, thank you.
Would you like some more hot coffee? What?
No, thank you.
This plane is going to be 48 hours late.
Well, that's nice. Hello.
Oh, God, you're awake.
Oh, well, so am I. What's your name?
Natalie, what's yours?
My name's Mike.
I'm terribly sorry that she disturbed you.
Oh, that's all right. She got lonesome, I guess, and needed somebody to talk to.
Don't you think you better go to sleep now?
Not the least bit sleepy.
Oh, why don't you let her sit there a minute? She's no trouble.
Oh, are you sure she won't disturb you?
No.
Don't you think Mike is handsome?
Well, I... Yes, I do.
Thanks.
Wouldn't you like me to tell you a story?
I don't think so, thank you.
Have you ever flown before?
Oh, yes. I love to watch the stars.
You do? Yeah, well, there's the Big Dipper out there. See it? And there's the Milky Way.
Did you know that the Big Dipper scoops up all the milk that passes through the sky?
Did you know that, Mike?
Well, actually, the Big Dipper, or Ursa Major, as it is called, is used very little to scoop up milk. For many years, the sailors have been using it to find Polaris, the North Star. That's the beacon light that guides them safely home from voyages all over the world.
You see that group of stars over there that resemble a big chair? That's Cassiopeia. It's known as the Seated Lady. Further south, just out of sight, are the Pleiades. Long ago, the Babylonians called them the Many Little Ones. The ancient Greeks called them the Seven Sisters. And to the American Indians, they were known as the Seven Brothers.
Do you know about the men in the moon?
I don't think Mr. Lawrence can answer that question, unless Mr. Lawrence has been to the moon.
I can tell you a little about the moon, Natalie. I've been there in a telescope. If you had a house on the moon, you'd never have to clean it, because there's no dust up there. And you wouldn't need any glass in your windows, because there's no rain or wind to keep out. And you can't hear any noise up there.
That would be nice.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Don't you think you ought to go to sleep now?
I think I could if I had my dog with me.
Well, where is he?
He's up in front with his suitcases.
Oh, well, you see, Natalie, I'm afraid the company can't allow animals back here.
What's his name, Natalie?
Poochie.
Poochie? Well, now, isn't that a coincidence? Only dogs named Poochie are allowed back here.
Oh.
I'll go get him.
Thank you. She's very pretty, isn't she?
She's very what?
Pretty.
Oh, yes, I guess she is.
Here he is, Natalie.
Oh, Poochie.
All right, let's go back to your seat, huh?
Can I stay with Mike?
Oh, why don't you let her stay here? There's plenty of room, really. There's
was
no
it
trouble,
all right?
Sure. No
well,
bother
fine,
at
all. All right, then. Let's get her a pillow.
A blanket. Tuck her in there. There we are. All right, Natalie, now go to sleep now. Just like you're at home.
There.
The blanket tucked in there.
Yeah.
Oh, there we are.
That's all right. Good night.
Good night. Sweet dreams.
Your hot chocolate.
Oh, good.
You know, for a minute, I thought I heard you bring a dog in here.
I did.
What?
I brought a dog in.
You read the rules lately?
Yeah, I've read the rules.
A cookie
says that we have to use our heads. There was a little girl who couldn't sleep. Now she has her dog and everybody can sleep. What's the harm in that? I'd gotten a chance to say goodbye to Mike.
Who?
Oh,
your VIP.
What that is. You know, I can't believe we're in Hollywood.
I bet Kathy's rented us a bungalow. Hope it isn't too fancy. Just a nice little place with a little backyard where we can lie out in the sun. Oh, here it is.
Peter, this is gonna look better in the dark.
Better get a key.
Wait a minute. Oh! Oh, no, what?
Oh, jam. Now, don't be silly. Come on, supposing it isn't the penthouse apartment, we've got to go in.
All right, you turn the lights on.
Okay, I will. You keep your eyes closed. Maybe all that.
Like something left over from Halloween. This room needs something, but I'm sure it isn't us. Where are the closets?
Look, you've lived here as long as I have. Oh, here's a door. See where that leads to.
What is it?
The bedroom.
Well, let me see.
Oh, no, no, stay right there. I'll bring it to you.
Did you sleep at all?
Nope. I stayed up counting light bulbs. You know, I could make a fortune. All I need to do is find a quiz show that wants to know how many times an hour Rick's sign goes on. The answer is 900.
Oh, that's awful.
I didn't mind that. What made me mad was that at 4:17 the sign went off and I didn't have a thing to do.
I had the craziest dream. I dreamt all night long people were knocking at our door.
You weren't dreaming. Seems that the former tenant of this dungeon was an exceedingly popular girl named Bubbles. Her friends kept trying to drop in all night.
Well, why didn't you wake me?
They wanted Bubbles.
I'll get it.
Bubbles doesn't live here anymore.
Yes, I know. Are you Marcy Lewis?
Yes.
Telephone for you downstairs in the hall.
I'm not back in an hour. There is no phone in the hall.
Thank you. Hello?
Yes, this is Marcy Lewis. Who? Oh, I see.
Who is it?
Miss Hale. Yes, Miss Hale. Oh, dear.
Something wrong?
If you'll wait a minute, I'll give you the full report.
But lots of time.
But it was my fault. Jan had nothing to do with this. You see, I was... Yes, Miss Hale. Yes, I understand. All right, I'll come in this afternoon. Goodbye.
You're in trouble, huh?
How do you spell catastrophe?
Well, now, let me see.
Guess who's been grounded for a week?
Oh, no.
Yes. Poochie had to pick a woman who collects cats. She reported me.
Well, I don't know what we're going to do. Well,
you're not going to do anything.
Leanne.
You are not. This is on me.
That hardly seems fair.
Well, I'm not worried, Jan. What I did was right. It just turned out wrong.
Certainly did.
I'm just afraid they're going to find out they can fly without me.
Oh, you're doing a land office business.
Yes.
Such a mess. We're just having it landscaped.
Oh, I know it's terrible, but honestly, Marcy, I couldn't find anything better.
You mean this isn't a joke?
Well, we all live in jokes like this. There's a housing shortage.
I can well believe it. You know, last night, she wouldn't come in until I turned the lights.
I've got it.
She's got it. Well, there goes the housing shortage.
I don't know why I didn't think of it before. There are four of us. And if we pool what we're paying right now, we could have a lovely little house.
Wonderful.
What do you say?
Oh, I say yes.
Yes, indeed. Now we can invite more than one boy at a time.
Listen, let's talk about it over luncheon.
Oh, where are we?
Oh, there's a wonderful restaurant where we all hang out.
Oh, good. Well, let's go.
Marcy.
What?
Where's your hat?
Oh, I'll get dressed in a hurry.
Jeez, it's a cute place.
You'd never mistake the cooking for mother's, but the prices are reasonable.
You mistake it for my mother. She's an awful cook. Look, let's order right away. I can't wait to start looking for a house.
Mm. Where is the best place to live?
We're going to have to take anything we can get. You know, Alice and I have to fly this afternoon, so if you'll drop us off at the airport, you can take the car and pick up a map, and then good luck.
Good.
It's a shame about you being grounded, Marcy.
Well, that's what I get for taking an interest in a small child.
You should get a look at that small child.
Mm. Oh, well, that's not what you think at all. He's some kind of a scientist. He communes with time and space and things.
Sounds just like a cousin of mine from South Carolina. They finally put him away.
What does he look like?
Oh, he's a cute little old kid. He was
quiet, Alice. Oh, I don't know. He's tall. He has light hair.
Jan.
Well, looks like your scientist also communes with spirits.
Excuse me.
Don't stare.
Hello.
Hello.
If you don't recognize me, it's because I'm out of uniform.
You're out of uniform? Oh, of course. You're Poochie's friend.
Ooh, let's not go into that. I want to talk to you.
Must be this apron. As soon as I put it on, everybody wants to talk to me.
What are you, flying bartender?
Oh, that? No. I flew to Chicago to attend a research conference.
Do bartenders have research conferences?
Oh, no. The university sent me back. I do this because, contrary to public opinion, graduate research students have to eat. That's what I am, graduate research student.
I see. I'm awfully glad.
Why?
Just confirms a feeling I had about you.
What kind of a feeling?
Oh, just a feeling. I'll be seeing you. What is that?
Old Oak Road, Old Oak Lane.
Seem to have misplaced Sunset Boulevard. What does it say on the map?
And it says we're lost.
Well, let me see.
You'll have to drop everything and leave for London by tomorrow.
Right, Mike.
Tell them I'm airmailing a whole new advertising campaign. I want you to report to me as soon as you've met with Henley.
This new campaign of yours is great. They're going to love it.
I hope so. Well, you better get going.
What is this, Old Oak?
Mm-hmm.
Well, there it is.
Good.
Now, let me see. I have to... Left, I have to turn.
Okay.
What's the matter? Battery's dead.
Oh.
So are we.
I don't know where I'm staying yet. I'll cable you as soon as I get there.
Okay, have a good trip, Otto.
Thanks, Mike. If you're the junior star...
Well, there's the car. Hey! Hey, wait a minute! He got away.
What's the matter?
The battery's dead.
We need a push.
You sure it's a battery?
I think so.
Got any gas in your tank?
Yeah.
Maybe your starter's stuck. Step out. I'll take a look at it.
All right.
Your battery's dead.
Isn't it nice to have a man around?
Will you give us a push? Get in the front seat, honey, and turn the wheels that way. We're going left.
Okay.
Turn the ignition on, put it in second, push your clutch in, and let it out, and we start to roll, okay?
Okay. Well, can't you push any harder?
As bad as the other.
It's a good thing this isn't a night flight. They'd both be baying at the moon. Wish Roger were a wolf.
What?
I do. My mother taught me how to handle a man who didn't treat me like a lady. Never one who did. Want me to get it?
No, I'll handle it. I've got a hunting license.
Hey, baby,
just
wait a minute.
Just a minute, please.
Good salesman never gives up. Oh, now look. For the 10th time, why won't you have dinner with me tonight in Chicago?
Well, I'm sorry, I never eat. Excuse me.
Oh, now look, honey.
Well, what do you say, baby? I got some pretty good connections in Old Shy. Instead of sitting in that little old hotel room looking at those little old walls, you and me could be having lots of fun.
Excuse me.
Oh, now wait a minute. Don't bother with that, Carrie. Look, come here. Here's the key to my suite. I'll expect you around 7. You'll have a little drinky, hang on the old feed bag, and you and I'll go on the town. How does that sound, huh?
Oh, boy.
How about that little celebration?
All right, what? You win. 7 o'clock.
Oh, boy.
Baggage checks?
Here we are, three of them.
Yes, hi, Marcy.
Hi, bud.
Pardon me. Haven't we met before?
No, we haven't, and that line's had it.
How's your battery?
You must be the gardener. But you're not a gardener. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't recognize your dress.
You didn't?
I mean, dressed up. If you're not a gardener, what do you do?
I'm in advertising. My name is Mike Tracy.
Mike?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm Marcy Lewis.
Hello, Marcy. Say, look, if you didn't like haven't we met before, you're really going to hate this, but it happens to be true. I have to take an important client and his wife to dinner tonight, and my date is at home with a virus. No, really, honest, would you like to join us? You could help me to spend that dollar you gave me.
Oh, well, I believe you, but I'm sorry, I just can't.
Well, that's too bad. Maybe some other time.
All right, and thanks again for the push.
Bye.
Hiya, Tex.
Hi, Marcy.
I missed your last two letters.
I don't know
you
why,
must
right?
You be Roger.
Oh, you must be Marcy.
I knew it was you because it's Chicago. In California, it's Bill.
Bill
Marcy,
who?
What are you talking about?
Or is it Tony? I don't know.
Bill,
it's
Tony?
Ridiculous. She's
what
kidding.
Is it? What's
what
going
doing?
On, Jan?
Oh, well, I've checked this out, so I'll be seeing
you. Oh, you're not going to leave now.
Oh, yes, I have a date. Standing right over there. So you kids, have fun.
Just wait till I get you alone.
Jan, I want to talk to you.
Oh, it's absolutely silly.
Oh, that's fine. Here we go. Thank you very much.
Mr. Tracy,
hmm?
I found out that I haven't anything to do tonight.
Oh?
Would you mind dropping me by the public library?
I'd love to.
Ah, good evening.
7 minutes late.
Clock watcher, I'd like to present Miss Lewis, Mrs. Bellamy, Mr. Bellamy.
How do you do, Mr. Bellamy? I'm afraid it's my fault. I had to get out of my uniform.
Waiter? What branch are you in?
Miss Lewis is an airline stewardess.
Oh? I had an aunt in the Navy. I've ordered champagne cocktails.
I hope you like them.
Yes, I do.
Well, here's to Mr. Bellamy's gardenia soap, which brings us all together on this pleasant occasion.
Oh, no, I think we ought to make a toast to Michael's lovely young lady.
Thank you.
Do you like being an airline's hostess, dear?
Oh, yes, I love it. I can't remember seeing you or Mr. Bellamy on any of my flights.
Well, you young ones can have the airplanes. I'll stick to the ground.
But I thought you were so interested in selling soap.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, does our airline use your soap?
I don't know.
But you should know. You're letting a big customer get away.
That's very true, my dear. But right now, selling one customer isn't our problem. We need to map out a whole new campaign. One that's just as effective as the last one.
Mr. Bellamy, I think I have it.
Yeah?
Has everything. Color, appeal, educational value.
Yeah, go on.
Well, we run a series of ads going back to the origins of soap. Show how they made soap in the old days. We could use posters of the pioneers. Contrast these posters with a modern gardenia soap plant.
I like that.
That stinks. If I want to educate people, I'll build a college.
All right, I'll find another approach.
Well, I have an idea.
I have a better one. Let's dance.
All right. Excuse me, Sue.
Sorry we got involved in business.
Oh, I didn't mind. Mr. Bellamy likes you, I can tell.
It's one thing about old Bellamy. He's got a tough exterior, but inside he has a heart of rock.
He was a little rough on your idea. You know, I have an idea.
And so have I. And it has nothing to do with gardenia soap. You know, you're a wonderful dancer.
You make me look good.
That's the way girls should talk. The art of flattering men seems to be lost. Women can't seem to lie the way they used to.
Well, we do all right. You know, I really think I know what would appeal to Mr. Bellamy.
Oh, honey, honey, look, the office is closed. Oh. Look, if you're so eager to sell gardenia soap, why don't you write him a letter?
I'm sorry.
That's the girl I've adored all these years. You see, if two people really love each other, these little spats can be patched up.
Yes, Mike.
I'm awfully glad the battery in your car ran down. We should celebrate every anniversary in a garage. Where would you like to go from here?
Oh, I don't care. Any place you like.
Maybe we should get home to the children?
Oh, I think the governess could take care of them all.
Oh. How many do we have?
6.
Darling.
Frankie?
I hate to leave you alone with all this stuff. The other kids flying too, I don't see how you can handle it.
Well, at least they'll have time to load their things in the car before they leave.
Yeah, once the trunks get here.
Well, old Mother Necessity will find a way. Look, you better get out of here before your passengers have to serve themselves.
Oh, okay, okay. I'll see you tomorrow at the new house.
Okay.
Oh, and Marcy, that's my best suit. Don't put it on the floor of the car.
All right, you know me. I don't make
Yes, I do.
Bye.
Bye.
Now.
You're new, huh?
Yes.
Well, I guess you'd be wanting milk.
Well, not right now. Would you do something for me?
Sure, what?
See the box up front?
Yeah.
Would you mind taking it out?
No trouble at all.
It's heavy.
I'll watch it.
Good morning. Moving in?
Good morning, yes.
I'm Bayview Bakery.
Oh. Well, there are going to be 4 of us. We're going to eat a lot of bread.
Yeah.
Say, would you give us a hand?
Pleasure, lady.
Thank you.
Marcy!
Hi, Mike.
I'm late. I went down the wrong street.
Oh, gee, you're an angel. Come over and help.
I think we can manage. No neon signs?
Hello. Hey,
that's quite a mansion you've got there.
Well, Mike, what are you doing here?
I just flew in from Boston, ran into Jane at the airport. She told me you were having trouble, so here I am. Troubleshooter Tracy, they call me.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is Mr. Lawrence, Mr. Tracy.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Well, what's the problem?
Well?
Simple logistics. We move these from here to there for you.
Thank you.
Careful, that one has got glass in it.
Yeah, okay.
For a go down?
Mike! When did you get in?
I got transferred to Mercury Run.
Why, that's wonderful.
Hey, what are you, a one-woman moving company?
Well, not exactly.
Gee, you look good.
Oh, thank you.
Well, with Captain Jameson on the job, your trouble's over, ma'am.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, not at all. Tomorrow the milk will be on the house.
Thank
I'll
you.
I'll leave the cake for you when I come by in the morning.
Thanks a lot. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Mr. Lawrence, Mr. Tracy, Captain Jameson.
All right, how do you do?
Listen, Mike.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Maybe we better go inside.
Hey, they're canning everything these days. Peterson family dinner. Everything from soup to dessert.
A friend of mine cans those.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of eating, Marcy, I have the evening off. I thought maybe if you weren't
oh,
busy
I'd
tonight...
Oh, I'd love to, Mike. I would. Well, wait a minute. I'll be right back.
It's that tomcat again. I told you we'd have to get rid of him.
Be careful.
Oops.
What'll the children say?
Say, do you really want six kids?
Yes.
Miss Lewis, in many ways, you're a very remarkable girl. Why don't we talk about it at dinner tonight?
Marcy!
Oh, you better go back to breaking dishes. Yeah?
I got the curtains up, but I've got a couple pieces left over. They're kind of little.
Oh, well, those are the tie backs. Here, I'll do that myself. Come on down, Skipper.
Oh, thanks. Altitude's beginning to get me anyway. Tie backs, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know much about that. There's a lot that I do know that I want to talk to you about at dinner tonight.
Can I rest for a minute, Mommy?
Why, sure.
Mommy?
Oh, yes, we have...
Marcy!
Yeah, Mike?
What else goes in the kitchen?
Well, there's one more carton, and I know just where it is. Oh, Mike!
Yeah.
Oh, dear. This will never do, will it?
Uh-uh.
Well, you be Mike. Mickey and Michael. Mike, Mickey, and Michael. How's that?
Why can't he be Mickey?
Because I'm Michael.
It couldn't be.
What's the
matter? Well, I'm on 24-hour reserve. That must be the airport. They're the only ones that know the number. Hello? Yes, this is she. Oh, yes. All right, I'll be right out. Thank you. I have to fly to Dallas in 40 minutes.
I'll run to the F.
Well, I have a car outside, thank you. Now, let me see. Flight bag. What'd I do with my uniform? Oh, talk to one another, will you please?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Mike!
Yeah, yeah.
I'm Mike.
Would you please unhitch the trailer for me?
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, I guess I'll be running along.
Yeah. Oh, you fellas have been so wonderful. Gee, I'm really going to have to go in the back door with this uniform on. I'll be grounded for good. Thanks a lot, fellas. Goodbye.
So long. Keep your flaps up.
See you.
Tiebacks, huh?
Been nice seeing you.
Yeah, likewise.
Mike.
Oh, Mike, this is wonderful. Did you do all of this while
I was...
How was
Dallas?
Well, the flight was canceled because of fog.
Oh, no.
I haven't eaten yet, if you'd still like to have dinner.
I don't think so.
Where are you going?
Look, this interior decorating is just a hobby with me. I'm a scientist.
Well, I know you're a scientist, but what's the matter?
Well, let's examine it scientifically, huh?
All right.
Premise. You needed some help.
Yes.
Argument. You got it.
Well, I appreciate
it. That phone call from the airport was very convenient. Kept things from getting too complicated. The coast clears, and you're back with some convenient fog.
Oh, my.
Conclusion? I think I'll stick to my test tubes.
But...
Night.
Before.
This is it.
So this is where you work.
Yep. Seems all I do is mix drinks.
Well, this is very interesting. You know, I didn't
know...
Would
you mind turning out the light, Marcy?
Turning out the light?
It has to be dark.
Dark for what? Now look, Professor.
Here we are.
Professor, what is it?
Living bacteria. It's called bioluminescence. Isn't that pretty?
Oh, it's beautiful. Would you mind explaining it to me?
Well, I wouldn't mind, Marcy, but I don't think you'd understand it.
Now, don't be a smug male. Tell me.
Very well. What I'm doing is an experiment with intensity, which varies in proportion to the velocity of reaction of the oxidative enzyme luciferase accompanied by luciferin, which is its substrate. Well, I warned you.
I must have missed something.
All right, let me explain it another way. Bioluminescence is a cold light.
Am I interrupting anything?
Oh, Dr. Hardy, come in. May I present Marcy Lewis? Dr. Hardy.
How do you do, Doctor?
How do you do?
I feel as though I know you. We used your books in my science classes.
That's a dirty trick to play on the young.
Science became my favorite subject.
Oh, you've got a pretty fine instructor right here. He was the guest lecturer at the research conference in Chicago.
Well, he didn't tell me.
I suppose you didn't tell her about the Bricker Fellowship, either.
Oh, I don't think Miss Lewis would be interested in that.
Oh, but I am.
Really? Of course she is. The Bricker Fellowship is awarded only once a year to an outstanding scientist. It's based on achievement and character. And this year, Mike is one of the nominees.
Well, that's a great honor.
Oh, it's very flattering, I think, too. If I win, it means a teaching job here. And I can go on with my experiments.
I hope you do.
I do, too.
Do you think you will, Doctor?
I'm not allowed to say. I'm on the selection committee. Oh, would you like to hear my relativity joke?
Oh, Dr.
Yes, I'd love
Hardy.
To.
Ask me to explain the theory of relativity.
All right. Will you explain the theory of relativity?
Well, when you're sitting in a dentist chair for 5 minutes, it seems like 5 years. But when you're holding a pretty girl in your lap for 5 minutes, it seems like 5 seconds.
I see.
When Einstein tells it, he gets belly laughs.
He never gives up on that story.
Well, someday you'll
you
see.
You bet. Someday it'll be one of the school traditions to talk about Dr. Hardy's relativity joke.
You love all of this, don't you, Mike?
You mean the lab?
The lab, the campus, your work. It shows in your face.
It does?
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid I'm just a teacher at heart.
Well, that's wonderful.
No, you're being polite.
No, I'm not.
You mention the word teacher to anybody, and right away they think of a little, underpaid, absent-minded Mr. Chips character, wearing an alpaca jacket and surrounded by dusty books. They don't understand. But teaching is just about as close to immortality as you can come. You know, in every class that you teach, someone will remember something you say. And because of it, his life will be changed a little. And he'll change someone else's life. And in that way, you become projected into the future. I'm lecturing. And you're not even registered.
I'm registered, Mike. My mother was a teacher.
Real? I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. You'd like mother.
Oh, I'm sure I would. You're not at all like I thought you'd be.
I'm not?
Uh-uh, not at all.
I was brought up in a little college town.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I love this life. Some people think it's sheltered and unimportant.
Oh, no.
It's terribly important.
I think so,
and very
too.
Exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Mike, I'm so glad we met.
So am I. Well, if you don't mind, Doctor... Oh, I guess he doesn't.
How was your date last night?
Oh, we had fun. He's a very remarkable young man.
What'd you do?
You want some coffee?
Mm-hmm. What'd you do last night?
Learned about bioluminescence.
Oh. Okay.
You want some coffee, Jen?
Mm-hmm. Please. Hello? Oh, yeah, that's
it. It's Mike.
Did you hear what she learned last night?
Good morning, Professor. How are all the test tubes? Oh, Mickey. Well, how are you? What happened? Well, I didn't...
Shh.
All right, I'll come down this afternoon. All right, I'll come down right away. All right, goodbye.
You seem to be in trouble again.
What did you...
You didn't say, but I did it. Well, oh, take this upstairs. I worry myself to death sometimes.
You know, maybe she shouldn't have learned
Alice,
about that.
Alice, finish your breakfast.
Yes.
I can't eat.
Miss Lewis, Mr. Tracy.
Marcy. This is Mr. Tanner, Mr.
How do you
Osgood.
Do?
How do you do?
Mr. Parker, our photographer. Mr. Hamilton, head of our art department.
How do you do?
Gentlemen, this is our little Marcy. Won't you sit right down over here?
We've certainly got to hand it to you, Miss Lewis.
You do?
It's all right, Marcy. We know all about it. We've heard from Bellamy.
Oh, how is he?
He's fine. Like a kid, full of enthusiasm. He's got the greatest advertising campaign in the history of his company lined up.
Why, that's wonderful, Mike. Is it yours?
No, yours.
Mine?
Didn't you write him a letter giving him an idea for gardenia soap?
Oh, yes. Remember that night we were dancing in Chicago, you told me to write him a note?
Uh-huh.
Well, I did.
You did?
Mm-hmm. Did he like it?
He's insane about it. And I use the word insane advisedly. He's talking bonuses. Honey, I spent 30 minutes on the phone this morning listening to him rave about this idea, and I don't even know what it's about.
It's a wonderful idea.
It is.
Miss Lewis, could you be a little bit more specific?
Well, of course.
That would be nice.
Well, the idea is this. You've seen pictures of actresses, socialites, and athletes endorsing different things, and I was thinking, why not airline stewardesses? I know people are interested in us because they're always asking me about our work, and if you use pictures of airline stewardesses all over the world, it would tie in with the idea that gardenia soap is the same under all conditions. You like it?
Like it? Like it? Honey, I think it's great. It's just great.
That's fine.
Osgood, I want you to get an exclusive tie-up with the airline. We're going to use 24 sheets all over the country.
Right.
Hamilton, give me a layout for a series of radio commercials. Use the marriage angle. The airline stewardesses have gotten married.
Oh, but they don't fly after they're married.
Strike the marriage angle. We'll keep them single. CJ, don't let's forget to call Bellamy.
Yes, good idea.
Parker, I want you to use a different stewardess for every layout. We'll make her the gardenia girl of the month. Get your girls to start shooting art. We can use backgrounds all over the world, but wherever they are, they're using gardenia soap. Got it?
Got it. One thing.
Yeah?
Who's going to be our first gardenia girl? All right now, Marcy. Hold it. Good. One second now, Marcy. Got it. Hold it. Ah, that's good. Now let's have one for the road, huh? You can relax a second.
Well, I'm comfortable.
Come in. Hi, kids. How's it going?
Hello, Mike.
Hello, Mike. Just finishing. There you go.
Got it? Tired?
No, this is fun.
Well, this should make it even more fun.
Mike, all of that for me?
All for you. Say, how about having dinner with me tonight?
Oh, I'm sorry. I have to take a flight out.
Oh.
Ooh, and I better get my clothes changed.
All right, I'll see you as soon as you get back. You and I are due for a long talk.
American Airlines Flight 455 calling Douglas request weather.
American Flight 455, this is Douglas Radio, Tucson, thunderstorm overhead moving east. Douglas overcast, visibility 5 miles.
American Airlines Flight 455, Bob.
We're sending down to Douglas.
Two sugars, that's your... You can't do that. I've got a dinner date in Los Angeles.
Now, ain't that too bad? Better get your passengers ready.
And don't give him any.
Well, the passengers are all taken care of. The bus just took them into town.
I just checked with the hotel. They got room enough for them, but that's all. I'm afraid the crew will have to sleep here. I got a cot back there that you're welcome to use, miss.
Well, thanks anyway. I'll stick with the troops.
You mean tell me that's the only hotel around here?
Well, there's the Adobe Inn, but that's no good. They're closed for the season. Wait a minute. Old Hawkins is still there. Oh, I forgot. Phone shut off. If you want to take a chance, my car's outside.
What do you say?
It's fine with me.
Well, let's pick up Benson. We'll go around and take a look at it.
Thank you.
See you.
Thank you. See you later.
We're sorry to intrude on you like this, but our plane ran into a little weather.
Well, the hotel is officially closed up, but I guess I can accommodate you.
Oh, good.
You folks want a room?
Two rooms.
Well, shouldn't be any trouble. You have 50 rooms to choose from. Come on in.
Thank you.
Flyers, eh?
Yeah.
I'll have to dig you up some fresh linen.
Could we get something to eat?
Oh, I don't know. I won't even eat my own cooking, and I ain't very particular.
Have you got any food?
Oh, sure, lady. We got food.
Well, if you show me the kitchen, I'll fix us something.
Oh, I love to eat. Hey. Come right this way.
She cooks.
Wow.
Some more coffee, Benson?
I've had it. My compliments to the chef. Mm.
Thank you.
I better check on the weather.
That's a good idea.
Can I get you anything, Mr. Hawkins?
Oh, no, thank you. I couldn't eat another bite.
See ya.
You know, that's the best meal I've had since the hotel closed up. Now you leave everything right here, and I'll clean it up in the morning. I better go get started on your rooms.
The nice old guy.
Yeah. There are only two pancakes left. Surely you can eat them.
Oh, no, Marcy, no. Gosh, I thought cooking like this was a lost art.
I love to cook.
Ah, this is nice. You realize we've never really had a chance to talk alone before?
I know. I can remember the time when you weren't very anxious to talk to me.
Remember the first day when I give you a lift?
When I forgot the lunches?
Oh.
I still can't figure out why you didn't let him fire me.
Well, it was something you said in the car.
Something I said?
That first day.
About pilots being chauffeurs?
Oh, no. Oh, about not really being alive unless you're in the air. I felt that way ever since I was a kid.
How long have you been flying, Mike?
So I took my first flying lesson. I was about 15.
Really?
In an old crate with wings. My old man found out about it and wailed the tar out of me, but it was too late.
Why?
Well, I got hung up in a cloud. I ran away from home and joined an air circus, barnstormed all over the country. Haven't owned an airline for a while.
You didn't?
Yeah. Consisted of one airplane and two engines. Then the war came along, and I joined up. You know, most people get tired of traveling around. But traveling affects me like some people are affected by money. More I get, the more I want.
I know.
Sure you do. But a lot of people don't. You know, you and I are alike, Marcy. We both come from small towns where people live and die and never travel any farther than the corner barbershop. That can never satisfy me. People at home don't seem to understand. They seem to think I'm running away from something.
Oh, I don't think you're running away from anything, Mike. I think you're running to something.
Hey, that's it. Exactly. You know, Marcy, this is a great big world we live in, filled with many languages. And I want to hear all of them before I die. I want to meet as many people as I can and find out what makes them tick, what they talk about and what they think about. I don't want to miss anything.
That's the way I feel, Mike.
Thank you.
I'm in the office to see you.
Who?
Only C.R. Smith, president of the airline.
C.R.? Now what did I do? Well, thanks, Joe.
To attention, por favor. Para American World Airways, anuncia la llegada del vuelo 584. Continente de México, Centro y Sudamérica. Los pasajeros saldrán por la...
These are good. Have you seen them?
Yes, fine.
Come in.
Hiya.
Hello, Marcy.
Hello, Mike. Mac. Mr. Osgood.
Yeah, this is C.R. Smith, your boss, Marcy Lewis.
Hello.
How do you do, sir?
Miss Lewis, I'd like you to explain why I pay a high-priced public relations department to do a job that you've knocked off in your spare time. This campaign of yours is great. Sensational, I think is the word.
That's the word, all right.
You like it?
He's crazy about it.
It's the biggest thing that's happened to us since a reversible propeller.
Here, Marcy, wait till you get a look at these pictures.
Aren't they just wonderful?
As quickly as possible.
One shot of you.
As soon as you okay the proof, we'll get a temporary layout.
Yeah, it's not a great shot.
Oh, Mark, these are wonderful.
Look what I had to work with.
I've arranged for you to get a nice bonus.
You see?
A bonus?
Uh-huh.
Oh, thank you.
Now, how would you like to spend some of that bonus on a fellow who hasn't got a thing to do tonight?
Huh? I'd like it.
You're all welcome to join us, of course.
I'd love to. Oh, I forgot. I've got another appointment.
Oh, isn't that too bad?
Thank you, Mac. We'll see you all later. Come on.
Marcy, will you tell me something?
What?
What are you doing as a stewardess?
I like it, Mike.
Yeah, sure, it's great. But not for the rest of your life.
I hadn't planned on being the oldest stewardess in the world.
You are a most surprising girl. Has anybody ever remembered to tell you that? You don't fall into any of the ordinary layout patterns. You're wonderful to look at. In advertising, that's impact. Most read, that's having you in sight. Most remembered, that's not having you in sight and wanting to. Marcy, you know, I think you'd like the kind of a life I live. It's almost like another world. The constant excitement of seeing your ideas come alive and start all kinds of wheels moving all over the earth. You get an idea today and tomorrow it influences millions of people you'll never even see. People in South America, Bombay, England. There's nothing to match it, Marcy.
You make it sound so wonderful, Mike.
More wine?
Mr. Bellamy, would you excuse him for a moment?
Certainly.
Excuse
me.
Dr. Hardy, you're not having a good time, and I don't think you know Captain Jameson.
How do you do,
Captain?
Now sit down,
all right.
Be comfortable.
I'm having a particularly good time. I'm supposed to be at a faculty dinner. Oh, Mike and I have just about finished our experiments in bioluminescence.
Really?
Yeah.
What?
Bioluminescence.
That's the emission of light from living organisms.
Oh, I see.
Well, pardon.
It must be very interesting being a pilot.
Oh, we get around. I don't like to be tied down myself. That's for the Kiwis.
For the what?
Well, that's a club the stewardesses join when they get married and can't fly anymore. It's named after an almost extinct bird in New Zealand that can't fly. Oh, Mr. Osgood, have you met everyone?
Yes, I believe I have. See, this is quite a party. Real impact.
That's an advertising phrase. It means balanced eye appeal. Oh, the cheese. I'll be right back.
Hello? Oh, yeah, just a minute. Marcy?
Yeah?
Telephone.
All right. Don't get up, doctor. Hello? Yes? Oh, no, Mac. Well, we're having a... Oh. All right, I'll be down in about 20 minutes. All right. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to leave for a few minutes.
What's wrong? What's wrong?
That was Mike Tracy's photographer. He needs one more picture to airmail to the East tonight. I'll only be a few minutes.
I'll drive you down.
Now, look, you two stay and enjoy the party. I'll slip out the back way.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Kind of a funny time to be taking pictures, isn't it?
I don't like it either.
Where'd you put my briefcase?
Oh, it's upstairs and down the hall.
Where's Tracy?
You don't think that...
I wouldn't put it past him. Oh. Hey,
Good evening, Mickey.
I'm Michael. You're Mickey.
Forgive me, Michael. Evening, Mike.
Oh, yeah.
Where's Marcy?
Don't you know?
Should I know?
Lins, you tell your photographer to call her to work tonight.
Parker? Did he call her?
Yeah.
He said he needed an extra picture tonight to send east.
I'll bet he did.
Don't you trust him?
I wouldn't trust him with Whistler's mother.
Oh, you wouldn't, huh?
No.
No?
No.
Fix your little drink, Marcy?
No, thanks.
Not even just a little teeny one?
Nope. I don't know why I have to wear this. All the other pictures were taken in uniform.
Yeah, I know. That's why I thought we'd add something different, you know, a little variety.
Oh, yeah, different, what there is of it.
Wow-wee.
You look great.
Yeah, but will I sell soap?
Honey, you could sell mud. Anybody ever tell you that you're a very unusual girl, Marcy?
Look, Mac, if you're in a romantic mood, go to the movies. I've got a house full of people waiting for me. Now, where do you want me?
I've known a lot of girls in my day, Marcy, but when I
tell you... Are you sure you asked me down here to take pictures?
Look, now, why don't you sit down here and relax? I've got a couple lights out.
The doorbell.
Out. Just about 1 second. I'll set
There's
this...
There's somebody at the door, Mac.
Take it easy. Take it easy.
Come on, get your clothes on. I'm getting you out of here.
Him.
Mrs. Caldwell, what do you expect?
From you, just about that. You're one of the primitives.
Marcy, what are you doing?
I'm taking pictures.
You think everything can be You're responsible for all this.
What
do you, Marcy, wouldn't be?
I'm going to remedy that right now.
Come on, Marcy, I'm taking you home.
Who do
you
think
you're
going
to
Look, I don't want to fight.
I'll bet you do.
Take it easy.
Why should I?
Fellas, stop it! You stop it!
Because I did a little boxing at college.
Come on, get on your feet.
I'm taking you home. Oh, you are, huh? Oh.
Photographer's studio, scene of Sunset Strip brawl.
Well, this ought to sell a lot of gardenia soap.
Boy, what a brawl.
How can you joke about this? The phone's been ringing all morning. Mike Lawrence is being disqualified for his fellowship, Mike Jameson has been grounded, and Mike Tracy lost the Bellamy account, and I've been suspended.
I'd say you'd had a busy day.
But, honey, worrying about it isn't going to help.
Well, I'd just like to unscramble it.
Darling, if you don't mind a suggestion, why don't you let them all alone before you get them all hanged? Well, anyway, one good thing's come out of all this.
What?
Roger saw the paper this morning. He's informed me that we're to be married right away.
Oh, he woke up.
I'm glad that's settled.
That's wonderful. Oh, I'm so happy for you, Jan. Just great.
Anybody want some more coffee? Alice?
Yeah, I wish.
Hold your cup up, sweetie. Kathy?
Mm-hmm. A little.
How's the toast?
I realize the fellowship depends partly on character, but Mike has one of the finest characters I've ever known, Dr. Hardy. And that's what makes me feel so bad. If he didn't care about people, he wouldn't have gone down there in the first place, and he wouldn't be in all this trouble. If he didn't care about people, what kind of a scientist would he make? Why would he want to devote his entire life to working and teaching to make life easier for all of us? Please. Don't take this opportunity away from him. It wasn't his fault. He had no idea this would happen. It isn't fair for you to take your account away from Mike because of this. He's impulsive. That's what makes him a creator. If it weren't for that, he wouldn't get ideas like the Gardenia Girl campaign, which is still great advertising. I don't have to tell you how lucky you are to have a man like Mike working for you. Look at his record. You can't dismiss that. Mr. Smith, Mike Jameson is the best pilot you have for the simple reason that flying is the most important thing in his life. If he weren't adventurous and courageous, he just wouldn't be Captain Mike Jameson.
This used to be such a quiet business before you came along, Marcy.
Well, I'm on suspension.
I know. I issued the order myself. It's none of my business, but what were you doing in that sarong?
Posing for the gardenia ad.
Oh, I wondered.
And then the fight started and I had to...
Yes, I read the rest of it. Look, if you can find something a little less colorful to wear, like our regulation uniform, you and Mike can go back to cloud hopping.
What do you mean by cloud hopping?
Well, that's up to Marcy.
Oh, she and Mike were getting along very well on the ground.
No, that's not what she needs. She needs a guy like Mike, who's creative, impulsive. She told me so herself.
Mr. Bellamy, you just heard Miss Lewis. She admires a man of courage.
Only she admires a man of character.
Now, wait a minute.
A man of character. I have to disagree
gentlemen,
with you.
She needs a pioneer.
I know this girl.
A man who will
direct...
American Airlines flight for the Mercury for Chicago and New York. Now boarding at American...
Hey, Marcy.
Hi, Mike.
Wait.
Oh, now, wait a minute. I've got to get aboard. Mike, I have to leave.
Look,
that's
not until
my
I talk
flight.
To you. Look, Marcy, I don't know how to say this,
Marcy,
but...
Marcy, I've got to talk to you.
Mike.
Alone.
Now, just a minute.
Please. Marcy, look, I've got to say this before
you
leave.
You don't mind.
Dan told me you were leaving.
This is important.
Well, I'm glad I got here.
Look, Marcy. I never thought I'd have to propose in front of a crowd, but... Marcy, will you marry me?
Oh, Mike.
Remember what we said about the world being filled with wonderful people talking strange languages? We could listen to them together. We've got the whole world to fly around in. You could be awfully happy, Marcy.
Marcy,
that's wrong for you. You and I are not going to watch history. We're going to make it. It's ideas that move the world, Marcy. That's where your excitement is, the same as mine. Besides, those six kids need a father.
Marcy.
Yes, Mike.
There's not much more I can say. All this sounds pretty wonderful.
Then why are you here, Mike?
Because I love you. Oh, Marcy, you don't have to say anything. Being married to a teacher wouldn't be very exciting, and...
Oh, you're gonna be surprised.
What?
Hello, Mr. Chips.
Mr. Chips.
Final call, American Airlines, flight for the Mercury.
Oh, that's us.
What's
up? We have to go.
Where are we going?
Oh, Mike.
Are you sure, Marcy?
Oh, yes. It's simple bioluminescence.
It's what?
He lights up.
Lights up?
Goodbye.
Go on.
Goodbye, Marcy. Marcy, here's your clearance slip. Hey, that's an extra passenger.
He's with me.
I'm with her. Hey, Marcy, you can't do that. It's against the rules. Marcy. She can't do that. It's against the rules.
Rules weren't made for Marcy.
They sure weren't.
Well, we got each other.
Yeah.